Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and I am proper getting my 90s kid vibe on at the moment. So I haven't done any 90s kid videos for a while, haven't talked about 90s much for a while. However, 2 days ago I saw the trailer for Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Once and Always. I have to say guys, it has got me very excited indeed. Now, being a 90s kid, Power Rangers was absolutely huge. I mean, there's not many kids that would have watched that program unless you had a parent who didn't like you watching violent kind of TV shows. I absolutely loved it. My friends started watching it before I did, and they started talking to me about it, and I didn't have a clue what they were on about. And then I got in the house and I found it myself, started watching that on the weekend, maybe early morning. Totally loved it. Teenagers of Attitude from Angel Grove. Morphing into spandex-clad heroes with their own weapons and Zords, Megazords against Rita Repulsa, Goldar, and a bunch of crazy, silly monsters like Pudgy Pig, Crazy Chicken, and anything, any kind of household items you can think of turned into a monster. That was pretty much Power Rangers, of course, based off Super Sentai in Japan. It was wild. It was awesome. It was colorful. It was robots. It was like everything kids loved, I guess. And then from that, of course, I had merchandise. I had toys. I can remember getting the original Megazord. Got a Megazord back there. I'm not gonna move it right because it took me ages to get that together, and I thought, yeah, there's a few things in front of it. It might come apart easy. Anyway. Yeah, so I remember having the original Megazord for Christmas. I'd opened up my presents, and then my mum and dad had their own kind of piles to the right under the tree. Mine used to all be in bags at that age on the settee. So I thought that was it. I had a few of the Power Rangers. I think I had like the red, blue, and black to begin with. And then they said, "Oh, there's one more for you about you. Look how did I get over there?" And there was the Megazord. I was like, "Awesome!" I loved it. I used to, of course, got the Power Rangers Mega Drive game, which is a fighter. So me and my friends have spent many hours playing this as kids. Oddly enough, I never had the Power Rangers the movie Mega Drive game. I don't think I knew it existed at the time. I think I only discovered it through YouTube like years later. So I don't own that. Maybe I will now try and get that. But in school, I can remember. I can't really remember playing Power Rangers with my friends in school, but I can remember daydreaming that I was a secret Power Ranger as a kid. I pretended my watch was my communicator. It does kind of look like a communicator, doesn't it? All that stuff. Loved it. Remember in the yard, if I was on my own. I've got weird memories of my primary school days, like, 'cause I know I spent a lot of like break times with the other kids playing, but I also spent some myself where I was pretending I was a Power Ranger fighting these monsters and stuff. Must have looked really bizarre if you were watching me. Some of the teachers watching me in the back then, this kid just kicking imaginary air in front of him. But yeah, Power Rangers was awesome. T-shirts, pencil cases, anything you can think of. My dad took me to go see the original movie in the cinema. Of course, Lord Zedd was in it as well, wasn't he? Amazing. So for me, I grew up with Power Rangers, started with Mighty Morphin. I watched all of Zeo. I went on to Turbo. Alien Rangers was in between those as well. Turbo was the last series I watched in full. After that, you had In Space. I lost a bit of interest then. I was getting a bit older. I was in like comprehensive school, and I kind of grew out of it. Says the guy in his late 30s with the Megazord behind him and who's been connecting the Power Rangers Lightning Collection for those series as mentioned, if you've been watching the channel. And there's another one down there to show you in my next pickups video. So there was a remake movie that came out, and I went to see that in the cinema with my friends, and I wasn't that into it, to be honest. I didn't think it was great. I don't like how they did Goldar at the end there and stuff, and I was like, ah, whatever. Of course, you're an adult now. You're not going to get the same feelings about this kind of series you did as a kid until I saw this trailer.
After all these years, I found a new buddy.
Wait, Repulsa?
No, it can't be.
It's time for revenge! Ah!
She killed Mom.
We gotta destroy her.
This is Ranger business, okay?
Let us sort this out. Rita's creating a time portal.
I'll kill you before Zordon makes you Rangers.
We gotta make sure Rita doesn't hurt anybody else.
Attention, Power Rangers! Get to your assigned stations now!
Once a Ranger?
Always a Ranger.
It's Morphin time!
Your Moon Rangers!
You wanna fight? You found one!
You got this! Good luck! Now it's a reunion!
Messing with this place is a big mistake. Don't worry, you saved the world before.
So what I love about this, guys, is the fact that Rita Repulsa's back. It looks proper good. It doesn't look like, you know, I thought when they mentioned the anniversary and the original's coming back, I thought it was one special one-off episode or maybe a two-parter where they go into the latest season of Power Rangers. Whatever that is, I have no idea. I think there's like a million now, pretty much. And I thought, oh, okay, they'll come back and they'll help the other Rangers. That's pretty cool. But no, it's a standalone thing. Rita Repulsa's back, and what I like about this is looks like the storyline they're going for, no spoilers because it's in the trailer, is about Trini's death, because the actress who played Trini passed away in a car accident quite young, not long after she filmed Power Rangers, I think. And of course they can't bring the original actress back for that, but you do have Billy, Zach, Catherine's there, second Pink Ranger. Amy Jo Johnson didn't want to go there. I don't think the guy who played Jason, I can't remember his name, Austin something, Scott, something like that. Jason David Frank turned it down and has since passed away very sadly. But yeah, for this one, it looks like Rita Repulsa kills Trini off and then her daughter's in it. And I'm pretty sure she's going to become the new Yellow Ranger and they're all going to band together and probably destroy Rita once and for all. Give us closure on our childhood, amazing, eh? So yeah, we're looking forward to it. It's great seeing them back. I see Aisha and Adam are in there, just wishing them good luck, and hopefully they'll have a bigger part, because they were quite cool as well. Some of the originals. I mean, not the original originals. So you've only got, like, Zach and Billy as the original originals, and you've got Rocky, the second Red Ranger, Kat, who is the second Pink Ranger, and so forth. But Alpha 5, Zordon, it's all there. It looks good. So I'm really excited for this one. So I will be tuning in on April 19th to watch that. What I want to know from you guys over in the comments below is, were you a Power Rangers fan? I know I've got subscribers of all different ages, so some of you might have been too old to watch at the time and completely missed it. But if you were a Power Rangers fan in the 90s and you watched it, are you going to watch this one? Are you too old? You decided, oh, I've left that back in the 90s. Or are you excited once again? Oh, this is cool. It's bringing it back. Let's have a look at this. So, yeah. I am excited to see what they do with it. And the trailer alone looks really good. I've watched it several times now. Anyway, guys, that's all from me. So, as ever, pretty much it's Morphin time.